Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Hi guys,
welcome back to my channel.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm actually low-key whispering. Ooh, and he's up. I was like, I'm low-key whispering because baby G is sleeping, but he just woke up. And I already told Alex that he has to do babysitting duties because I'm about to sit down and have a whole ass talk through video with you guys. So this video is going to be me talking to you guys about my cuarentena, kind of what I did to lose my baby weight, and then also what I did, you know, to try and take care of myself postpartum after the baby. So I am currently 50 days, according to my math, 50 days postpartum. So I am actually like 10 whole days past the cuarentena. So this video is a little bit long overdue, but I am obviously recording it now. What are you gonna do while I sit down and talk to my friend? Huh?
Make sure he doesn't wake up. Because I'm tired.
Guys, this bouncer is badass. It's automatic, so it bounces by itself. But look, let it go, babe. This is how fast it bounces on itself, so it's not as hard. And he likes like the heavy movement, huh? Like the hello.
He likes it like aggressive.
Yeah.
Like he likes feet.
Aggressive. Be aggressive. And his swing also comes in handy, but there's some days that he's just feeling the swing. There's some days that he's feeling the bouncer.
He feels this one way more than that one, for sure.
No, I feel like he also likes the swing, but y'all have some fun while I go and do some talking. Okay, well, I am so happy that I'm finally getting around to recording this video. Like I was telling you guys, I have been meaning to record this video, but it has been taking me forever. But I'm kind of glad that it's a little bit past the 40 days. That way I can give you guys like a pretty good, I guess, summary of everything. I was initially going to record this video when I was about 30 days postpartum. I don't know why I didn't end up recording that video, but now I'm kind of glad because I am like fully done with my cuarentena and like my 40 days and stuff. So I did already have a couple of topics and certain things that I for sure knew I wanted to like talk to you guys about in this video. But yesterday on my Instagram, I did go on my stories and told you guys to ask me anything that you guys wanted to know about my cuarentena, or kind of what I did to try and lose my body weight and what I did to take care of myself postpartum, which I'm glad I did because you guys asked me a couple of things that I didn't have like down in my notes. And I do notes on my phone every time that I do kind of like these kind of videos where I kind of sit down and talk to you guys about something, because once I'm sitting down, se me va la onda and I kind of forget exactly like every single thing that I wanted to cover with you guys. So I do have my little notes right here, as well as the questions of screenshots of the questions that you guys asked me. And I do want to say a huge disclaimer. I feel like these kind of videos I have to say a disclaimer every single time, and even though I do say disclaimers and I'm like hello, like, you know, putting it out there in big words, people will still come for me. But I do want to say I am in no way, shape or form any kind of professional, any kind of health professional, any kind of postpartum professional. I am not a cuarentena professional. I did not go to college and studied cuarentena. So everything that I'm going to tell you guys is just things that my mom told me. And I told my mom, like, mom, tell me like more myths and, you know, more things about the cuarentena so I can tell you guys about it. And she's like, they are not myths, Les. This is reality. Esa es la realidad. No son mitos or anything like that. So my mom strongly believes that this is like facts. But to a lot of people, the cuarentena is kind of, you know, just creencias and like, you know, I'm not too sure if it's just a Mexican thing, but a lot of people don't think it's like real actual science. It's kind of just, you know, like things that you kind of grow up with and como te tienes que cuidar after you have your baby and like kind of what you have to do postpartum. To me, por sí o por no, I kind of did everything what my mom told me because, you know, obviously she's my mom. I trust my mom. So if my mom told me like, you know, don't pick up a penny because it's bad for the baby or whatever the case was, and I wouldn't pick up a penny. But again, I do want to put it out there that my mom is not a professional, even though she thinks she is. Just kidding. But my mom's not a professional. I'm not a professional. She was just telling me that all of this her mom told her to do, and her mom's mom told her to do, and her mom's mom told her to do. You know what I mean? Because I know when I did my breastfeeding video, even in the title it said it's my experience, it's what I did, people were like, oh my god, that is not right, you know, like you have to be educated on this and that. And I was like, holiday hibby weddy. And I literally just sat there and like told you guys my experience on breastfeeding and stuff. So yeah, I want to make it really, really clear on that. If you are looking for professional answers on what to do postpartum, this is definitely not where you should be. But if you are just trying to chismear, sit on your couch, eat some hot Cheetos while I talk to you, then this is definitely the place. I like to sit down here and talk to you guys as if I was talking to a friend or to a prima, like, oh dude, this is what I did, you know, this is what my mom told me to do, that is it. I just like to talk to you guys as if you guys were my friends and just sit here and chismear with you guys for a little bit. For my breastfeeding video, probably I didn't make that super clear. You know, somebody was saying like, oh my god, she's telling girls that if they have big boobs they can breastfeed. I was like,
bruh,
sissy, like, when did I say that? I was just saying me, to me it happened to be that my boobs, blah 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 blah. So I hope I made that really, really clear. I just want to sit here with you guys, chit chat for a little bit on what I did. I am going to my notes. So the cuarentena, aka cuarenta, 40 in Spanish, is 40 days that you are supposed to take care of yourself postpartum after having your baby. So the best way that my mom explained it to me, and I always growing up, I always heard the cuarentena this, cuarentena that, you know, like when my tías and my cousins would have babies and stuff. Dude, I'm talking super fast, huh? I'm sorry. I feel like if you've been with me for a while, like,
you don't even notice how fast I talk. But if this is like one of your first videos watching of me, you're probably like, bruh, is this girl on crack? But you'll get used to it, I promise. I try to slow down sometimes, especially with sit down videos, but my brain is just like on crack. So yeah, that is the quarantena, 40 days postpartum, taking care of yourself. The best way that my mom explained it to me is after you give birth, after you have your baby, tienes 40 poros abiertos, you have 40 pores open, and every single day, one pore is closing. So, you know, right after you leave the hospital, 40 of your pores are open, which is why it's called the quarantena, porque cada día a pore closes, which is why you should wait, take care of yourself. For those 40 days, at first, I didn't think the quarantena was such a big deal, you know, like taking care of yourself after the baby was that big of a deal. But my mom started telling me like all these crazy stories that happened to my tia and to my cousin and to her amiga, like in 1963 and shit, and I literally started panicking, like, oh my god, you know, which is crazy because we see bad things happening all the time around the world, but we never think it's gonna happen to us, you know. So I don't know, I was just like, por si o por no, I'm gonna like try and take care of myself the best that I can. So also guys, I did not, you know, I was not perfect in this, I was not super super strict as I wish I would have been, especially with the dieta and all of that, but I did try the most that I could, even though, you know, I did cheat here and there. So the main question that you guys asked me a lot was about fajas. So you guys asked me about, when did I fajarme, what faja was I using, where did I get my faja, everything about fajas. I actually have pictures, videos, and all of that that I will be sharing with you guys. I'll leave this towards the end of the video just because I feel like a lot of you guys probably don't care about the fajas, but in case you do, you're actually just here for the fajas. I'll leave a timestamp right here as to where to fast forward. If you just want to know about the fajas, I'll do that towards the end, because for that, I do want to really go into detail about the fajas. But then again, I don't want to bore you if you don't care about that. But there was a lot of questions about the fajada life, so I'm gonna leave that towards the end so I can really go into detail with you guys. So mainly for the 40 days that you're taking care of yourself, you're supposed to taparte, cover yourself completely, especially because I gave birth in the winter, because of course it's really cold outside. So leaving the hospital, my mom covered my ears, she covered my feet, me tapó el pecho, literally covered me everywhere. So cover yourself really good so no air goes in you, para que no te entre nada de aire, because te puedes hinchar o te puedes torcer. So my little notes are in Spanish since my mom does not know English, and she's the one that was like telling me everything about the quarantine and stuff. So I'm gonna try my best to translate it in English. But yeah, basically cover, you know, your ears, your feet, your chest, and everything, because you can get bloated, like air is gonna go inside you because you're so fresh out of birth. It can be like a facial stroke or facial paralysis. So that's the main reasons why you have to like cover yourself really good, especially if you are giving birth in the winter when it is really cold outside. So yeah, that was like the main thing to my mom, like tapate, 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 cover yourself, do not leave the house, again, especially because it was really cold outside, and obviously our house is warm, so it's really bad to go like from warm to cold temperature overall, especially, you know, if you just gave birth. Another thing was for me to not get near the stove. She told me to not get near the stove or to not get near the fridge. And actually yesterday I was like, wait, mom, why could I not get near the stove? And it's because I was breastfeeding. Is it te puedes secar la leche? Your milk can dry out if you get near the stove. That's what she told me. Some of these things I'm like, mom, those are myths for sure. She's like, no, these are facts. So I don't know, to each their own. And so, like I told you guys, I was breastfeeding the first couple of days. She was coming over to cook for us, or Alex's mom would cook for us, because they did not want me near the stove, and then the fridge, well, because it's cold and she didn't want for me to open the door and then for the cold air of the fridge to hit me. So yeah, don't get near the stove, don't get near the fridge. I was like, say no more. So for as far as diet, of course I was trying to like watch what I was eating and everything. I do have pictures, I can't believe I'm barely saying this, but I do have pictures of what I looked like right after the hospital. So literally the day that I left the hospital, I took this picture right here, and as you can see, I was still super panzona. It looks like if I was, what, 7 months pregnant still. And even my mom, my sister, and like my suegra and stuff were like, oh my god, like quedaste super inflada still, you know what I mean? We're all different. A lot of the times the day that you have your baby, your stomach obviously doesn't go back to how it was, pero si se te desinfla mucho. And me, as you guys saw, guys, I was still super panzona. Low-key, I was like, oh my god, like, you know, it was crazy because before I got pregnant, if you guys have been following me that long, I had a really nice flat stomach back in the day. So to see my body like that with no baby inside, because you guys were asking me too, like, how did I feel about it? And honestly, I was a little bit concerned. I was a little bit sad. Of course, I didn't feel like the hottest person out there. But in the back of my head, you know, I knew I had just given birth to a baby. So that's also another thing. And this was also kind of hard for me to kind of accept. So it's easier said than done, but you know, you have to understand that you did grow a whole ass human inside of your belly for a whole 10 months. So you can't expect for your body to bounce back in a month, in a week, nor especially the day after. Like, of course you're gonna look so much different. For me, this baby completely changed me. My stomach, especially my boobs, like the main thing that he changed. My boobs have not really gone down size-wise, but they have gone down a lot, like literally down tier or whatever, I am still a triple D, except now I am a saggy ass triple D. When I was pregnant, it was like a triple D, but it'll kind of up here, I think, because it would fall on my stomach. Now that the baby's out, my boobs are still really big and they're just really saggy. Honestly, I cannot wait to get a breast reduction, and I'm gonna get, like, you know, pros and cons about all of that. And I'm so sorry, guys, if this video is kind of all over the place. I'm trying to, like, put all my thoughts together when it comes to this, because there's just, you know, a lot of little topics about this, so I'm kind of trying to throw it all for you guys in one video. So if I'm all over the place, I do apologize. But yeah, for the dieting, there's so many diets, different diets that you can do, you know, to try and lose your baby weight. What I did though was I completely cut off, even though I have never really been like a big sodera, a big soda girl, I completely cut off any kind of soda, because the soda does have a lot of gas. So my mom would tell me that me iba a inflar, I was gonna get like super bloated, you know, especially post if I started drinking sodas. Also drinking alcohol, I did not drink at all, 0% alcohol, only on my birthday. I had one beer and one shot on my birthday, but other than that, the whole quarantine I did not drink whatsoever. And I try to cut off flour as much as I could, so every time that we would eat, I would always I'm the type to eat siempre with tortilla de harina. So I'm not saying that I did not touch tortilla de harina at all, but I did try to cut it. Also, when I was pregnant, dude, I would eat. Like, I didn't care. That was my excuse. I am pregnant and I was stuffing my face, which is crazy though, because I told you guys my whole pregnancy that I didn't have like a crazy ass appetite being pregnant, even though I thought I would, but I didn't. And like, I was gonna use that as my excuse. Like, I'm pregnant, I can do whatever I want. But actually, I didn't have like no crazy like appetite and querer, you know, atascarme or whatever. So yeah, once, as far as my diet, I was also just not eating as much. So I would only eat if I was hungry. And to some of you guys, it might sound like, duh, you eat when you're hungry. But no, dude, a lot of the times we eat even when we're not hungry, or we're eating and we're already full and we keep eating and eating and eating. And I feel like that's what makes you gain weight, or like, you know, really bump up your weight. So I would eat, you know, and if I was full, that was it. I would stop and I would only have 2 to 3 meals a day, which again might sound obvious, but no, a lot of us be having 4, 5, 6 meals a day. And again, I feel like that's what makes you, you know, gain your weight. So no flours for me, no soda. And I was only having 2 meals a day, maybe 3. But I was not starving myself. I'm not saying to starve yourself. You know, if you're hungry, eat something like an apple, a cucumber, or something that's gonna obviously feed your stomach, but don't go and eat yourself like some bistec tacos and, you know, a burger and stuff like that. So just little things like that. You guys would ask me like what exact diet I was doing, and I didn't go by any strict diet. I was just kind of like, okay, my baby's out, I no longer have an excuse. I do want to bounce back, of course. So, you know, just watching myself here and there on what I was eating, because I know I had mentioned the quarantena and I had posted I was eating hot noodles, and a lot of you guys were like, wait, I thought you were on a diet, I thought you were on the quarantena. And I was like, baby girl, I was watching what I was eating, but no super strict diet. Also, a big, I guess, advantage that I had was that while I was pregnant, I'm telling you guys, I didn't really have no crazy appetite. So I didn't really gain weight from like my body besides my belly. So I was pretty much, I want to say, all belly throughout my pregnancy. So I guess that was a pretty good thing, because after my baby, all I had to do was lose my big belly that you guys saw and stuff. So also, do not sweep and do not mop, because you are straight out of birth, and it is best for you to not bend too heavily, to not stand up too heavily, to not do any kind of force. You literally just gave birth, guys, to a whole ass human. And my mom kept telling me this over and over, but I was the type to be like, oh my god, I just gave birth to a baby, like, no big deal. But no, it's actually a really, really big deal, you know, to take care of yourself. Again, I was not, you know, perfect when it came to it. I did, you know, do things here and there that my mom probably wouldn't have approved of. Really just kind of let your body rest, let your body get back to where it is supposed to be. So now, I know on my breastfeeding video, I posted pictures of my boobs, what my boobs looked like after I gave birth to a baby, how huge they were. I haven't posted pictures of what my boobs look like now, which I am not, just because they are nowhere near where I want them to be. Now, to answer some of these questions, somebody told me, how is your stomach so flat? Did you have some kind of little surgery or anything like that? So no, guys, even if I wanted to have any kind of surgery right now, I believe you cannot get any kind of surgeries. I don't know if it's 6 months or 8 months, but I am only 6 weeks postpartum. I cannot get, even if I wanted to, any kind of surgeries right now, and my stomach is not super flat. So for Instagram, like anything, of course, I pick my best angles to post pictures. And in some pictures, I can make my body look, you know, like a really flat stomach because of the angle, you know. Let me show you guys. So if I'm gonna post a picture on Instagram, of course I'm gonna pick my best angles. So, you know, I'm not gonna post like this. Of course I'm going to, you know, stand up, suck in my stomach, not breathe for a little bit, tick, 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 which I think every single girl is going to, you know, stand up really straight and suck in your stomach a little bit and pick a nice pose when you post a picture for Instagram. That's also why I kind of like to be on YouTube, on live, and on Instagram, because I feel like on YouTube you guys see, well, this. On live, you guys see me fully raw, and then on Instagram you see like the best side of me, because of course on Instagram I do make my pictures as nice as I can get them, you know, so I post a certain way, you know, I edit the light and things like that. But to show you guys my stomach is actually, I mean, it's not what it used to be, you know, when I gave birth, but I do not have a flat stomach. I am still working on it, even though I could see where you guys are getting, you know, that my stomach is flat. Somebody also asked me, did I get any stretch marks? Yes. So I never posted pictures of close up of my belly, but towards the end of my pregnancy, somebody had mentioned like, oh my God, you have a perfect belly. You didn't get any kind of stretch marks, but I did get stretch marks, guys. Funny thing though, I only got them on my right side of my belly. So I have stretch marks all down, like right here. All of this is full of stretch marks, and also on my legs right here, and also right here on my legs, and like right here on my butt, I got a lot of stretch marks, and those didn't really come in till after I had the baby. They were kind of there while I was pregnant, but as soon as baby G came out, my stretch marks right here big time came out. And I don't know if you guys, a couple of you guys have called it out, so I know y'all be checking me out. He definitely gave me more hips and some butt, and I can tell by my stretch marks they are pretty high, so I think you might be able to see like the bottom of them with shorts. Also, fun fact, if you have me on Twitter, I told you guys, if not, I'll leave my Twitter right here. I talk to you guys there on there a lot. Also, why is it bad to leave the house for 40 days? So it's not bad to leave the house, like the fact that you're leaving is not bad. It's just because pa que no te entre aire, so because of the weather change. Again, I gave birth in the winter, so it was really cold outside. So my mom was like, if you do not have to leave the house, do not leave the house. I think I left the house like 3 times during the quarantena, and those 3 times was because I absolutely had to go. But for the most part, I tried to not leave my house whatsoever, like to go to the store or anything like that. Alex would go. Also, do you still drink the tea? So I think she's asking about the detox tea. If you haven't followed me for a while, you know that I always used to talk about this one tea. So this tea, I drink it at night, and in the morning, first thing in the morning, I am in the restroom unloading myself, if y'all know what I mean, losing a couple of pounds and stuff. This tea, I was drinking it before I got pregnant to maintain my weight. Of course, when I got pregnant, I stopped taking it for obvious reasons. And now I started taking it 2 weeks ago. I did not want to take it like right after giving birth because I felt like my stomach was, you know, still trying to rearrange itself. So I didn't want to like drink this one tea that was going to like flush me out. So I did give it a couple of weeks before I started drinking that again. So I guess probably about 2 weeks ago, like towards the end of my quarantena, I did start drinking that tea again. I will link that tea down below. I do have a code if you guys want to use it. Also, towards the end, guys, I'm going to post pictures here and videos on the progress of my body, but that I am going to do it at the end when I talk about the fajas, because that has to do with the fajas and how my body started looking different when I was using the fajas. So are you officially back into your pre-baby body, and did you get any stretch marks? So I already answered the stretch marks. Pre-baby body, no, I am not. Weight wise, before getting pregnant, I was 125, and then at the end of my pregnancy I did go up all the way to 162, and now I am down to 130. So I am 5 pounds more than what I used to be before getting pregnant. Okay, so now on to the fajas. That was basically everything as far as, you know, the quarantena, on things that I did not faja wise. I literally started looking into fajas, asking my mom, asking my sister, like about the fajas that they used, which one was a good one. Take a shot every time I say fajas. Which one was a good one, which one wasn't, because I really wanted to, I mean, I think we all do, you know, want to snatch back to what you were before having your baby. I'm gonna kind of post clips and videos here as I'm talking about the fajas on the progress. So as I had showed you guys, this right here is what I looked like literally a day after leaving the hospital. I'm looking at the dates that I have up here. This was literally the exact same day, but with a faja. So it's crazy how much the faja like me metió la panza, literally same day picture. And this is the faja that I was using. Well, I mean, this one is the one that I'm using now, but on the picture, I am wearing a size small. So I started wearing my faja literally the day that I left the hospital. So we left the hospital, I came home, y me puse la faja. I asked my mom and I asked my doctor, like, are you sure? Especially because I was so panzona, I was like, are you sure it's okay for me to, like, you know, squish my stomach in like that? And they said it is completely fine as long as I'm not in pain or it doesn't hurt. So this was size small the first the first day, and as you guys can see right here, I was on the third button, and then within days I would go down buttons. So these fajas do come with these three buckles. Obviously you start on the third one and then, you know, you progress until it is on the tightest one. If I add random emojis around the pictures, it's because a titty was out or something was out. So this one was 3 days afterwards of wearing the faja. This is what the faja looks like from the side. So you can see that my stomach has gone down a little bit. I was wearing the faja, guys, all day, but I would not sleep with it. I was so desperate, honestly, to just like see my stomach go down, because I was like, what the heck, like there's no baby inside of me, why is my stomach still so big? But my mom kept telling me like, Liz, you just gave birth, acabas de tener un niño and stuff, you know. So I'm kind of glad she was kind of hard on me in that aspect, like telling me like, chill, you just had a baby, because I was so anxious to kind of lose weight. So now I can sit here and tell you guys what my mom told me, which is, you know, if you are 2, 3, 4 days postpartum and you see yourself completely different, take a breather, it is okay. You literally just gave birth to a whole human. You grew a whole human inside of you for 10 months. So, you know, coming from me, take a breather. There is no rush. You will get there. Don't be too hard on yourself, because I feel like I was pretty hard on myself, you know, the first days, because I was like, what the heck? Low-key, I was thinking there was still like another baby in there or something because of how panzona I was. And then these are just pictures also 4 days after wearing the faja. So you guys can see my stomach is slowly starting to go down, not fully, but it is going down. And then this one right here is also 4 days of wearing the faja. I know I'm kind of stuck on day 3 and 4, but that's when I was like the most hinchada and the most panzona, that's when I was taking the most videos and stuff. So as you guys can see here, how much, dude, the faja was already metiéndome la panza. I was telling you guys that I did not sleep with it. Like I was telling you guys, at some point I was so desperate for my panza to go away that I wanted to sleep with it, but my mom told me not to. She's like, do not sleep with it, use the nighttime when you sleep para descansar, to let your body rest, you know, to sleep. But then when you wake up, put it on, do not take it off until the night. And then these fajas do come with a hole at the bottom, so you put it on and you do not have to take it off at all until you go to sleep, because I know some of them don't come with the hole and it can be a hassle, so going to the restroom, having to take it off and put it on, especially when it is a new faja, because you have to lay down. Alex was helping me put on the fajas because of how tight it was, so he would only have to help me in the morning, and then all day I was wearing it, and then at night I would take it off. This one is 6 days, so like a week after coming home, and I'm not wearing the faja here, as you guys can see, and my stomach had gone down quite a lot. This is the same thing. Those little circles that you see in my stomach is because I still had them from the monitors that they had to hear the baby's heartbeat. So yeah, this was 6 days after, and this one was now 7 days after. So you guys can kind of just see my stomach going down. This was the first video that I did recording myself putting on the faja. This one was exactly a week and 1 day after having the baby. And I believe this was a size small. Yeah, this was a size small in the faja, and I was already going to the third button. And I was able to put it on by myself. The faja would really help suck it in. And of course, it being sucked in all day, that's what made my stomach, you know, go down pretty speedy. So after I put it on, here is a picture of what it looks like already on the third button. So I kind of wondered what my stomach would have looked like si no me hubiera fajado. But I mean, of course, I wasn't going to like test it out, you know, like, oh, let me see if I stay like panzona still. But I wonder, like, not fajándote, how your stomach looks. Again, I was not about to test that out with myself, but this one was a week and 3 days of me wearing the faja. My stomach has gone down a lot. I still have a belly there, obviously, but compared from day one, dude, big time went down. And then right next to it, I'm gonna put the picture of what it looks like with the faja. And then right here is when I decided to go down to an extra small. So I started off with the small faja, and then now I decided to go down to an extra small, because on the small I was already on the third button and I wanted to like snatch myself more, so I went down a size. So as far as faja size, I recommend whatever size you are right now to go down a size. So if you're normally a size large and close, go down to buy a medium. If you're normally a size medium and close, buy a faja small. Para que te quede apretada, you know, that's the point of a faja, for it to like snatch you up. So this one right here was 2 weeks with the faja, and this is where I finally started to like notice notice a big difference. Of course, I was seeing myself in the mirror every single day and I was like, my panza's not going down. And this one right here, I sent it to my mom and then I compared it to like when I left the hospital and I was like, oh my God, my panza has gone down a lot actually. Pretty proud of myself, pretty happy, because I felt like my progress was going pretty fast. But again, I was super, super consistent on the faja. And also I was wearing a little gel. This one I would put it on in the morning, and then in the afternoon, si me acordaba again, I would put it on again. This one does not have any oil, so it would not stain my faja. It was water-based, which is also why I loved it. I will leave it down below. That pomada and stuff says that it is for stretch marks, it is for bloating, it is for cellulite and all of that. So I will link the little pomada down below as well as the fajas. And this is a picture that I'm telling you guys that I put the two pictures together, and that's when I was like able to really notice, you know, that I was making some progress and stuff, and which was about 2 weeks postpartum. If you do buy a faja and you kind of can't do it by yourself, that does not mean it doesn't fit you. Have somebody help you, your husband, your boyfriend, your friend or something, your mom. Lay down in bed, stick in your stomach, and then have them sip it up, and then within time you're going to be able to do it by yourself, because obviously, you know, your body is going to shrink. Even if you do struggle a lot to put it on, it is fine, because you do not have to take it off at all during the day. I'm telling you that you can pee and poop. I've tried it with the hole that it has at the bottom, so en la noche ya nomás te la quitas, and it's only once a day that you have to, like, you know, struggle to put it on. This right here was also at about 2 weeks. I was wearing a size extra small, and then I was on the second button. When I laid down, my stomach, hello.
Mommy, me and dad want to play Fortnite.
I've been talking forever. I thought this video wouldn't be that long, but guys, I'm just like blah, 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 ranting. Okay, so you guys kind of got the point of me wearing the faja every single day. Basically, everything that I just talked to you guys about was the first 2 weeks. And I feel like if you are really consistent with your faja and like wearing the pomada and stuff for the first 2 weeks, you will notice a big difference. Because at this point, I feel like my pregnancy belly was gone. Now I just had to work on like my actual loose skin, loose stomach, which let me tell you guys, that has been the hardest part for me. I feel like at this point, I kind of got stuck. Like the first 2 weeks, I was like, boo, da, 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 da. Like my stomach just kind of like went really fast. And then now I'm like, hello. These right here are now where I am at. So I am still working on myself. I still have the line that goes down my stomach. My belly is still like super stretched out, super saggy. So yeah, guys, this is where I am currently at. I am stopping right here as far as faja size. I am still working on my weight. I still want to lose a little bit of weight. I definitely want to tone up my stomach still, but I think this is the perfect size as to where I want to stay. As you guys can see here, my waist looks pretty tiny right here, but I obviously don't look like that without it. Also, these fajas, so this is the faja that I have right here. She has them all in nude and in black. When the faja starts fitting you too loose, you don't have to go and buy yourself another faja. I know these are a little bit pricey, so all you have to do for it to like apretarte, of course, from the stomach is, again, is you guys see this line that it comes with? You just sew this line down here so it fits you tighter. So one faja can go a long way. You can just sew it from the back and you have yourself a size down faja. And I know a lot of you guys had asked me what faja I use and where it is from, so I will leave the link to the website down below. So when you click on the link and go to her website, she does have a bunch of fajas, and I asked her what was the difference between this one and this one and this one. So my faja, the specific one that I wear, is called Summer Gabby Faja Shapewear. And I have it in black and I have it in nude, literally the same thing. I just have both colors. So all of the fajas in her website come in nude and come in black. And I asked her like what was the difference of this faja and that faja. Guys, all the fajas in her website are the exact same. The only difference, the only thing that changes, is the thickness of the straps and how long they are from the shorts. So if the Gabby one, which is mine, is sold out, just know that all the other ones are the exact same. They are just gonna have either thicker straps or longer legs. So me, I don't mind the thin straps, but some of you guys would want the thick straps. You probably have a wider back or have more fat in your stomach, and the thin straps, you know, indent in your back. So that's what the thick straps are for. Or some of you guys, these might be too short. You probably want something that goes, you know, a little bit lower in your leg, because this can also indent your leg if you have more fat in your legs or chubbier legs. So yeah, just know all her fajas are the exact same material. Only the thickness in the straps and the length of the short changes. So for this one, you see how the straps in the back are thicker for those of you guys who might have more fat in your back, and mine are thin. So some of you guys might want this one but with the thick straps, or this one, but with the longer short. So yeah, I really wanted to put that out there because myself, I was like, wait, what's the difference between all these fajas? So yeah, I will leave her website down below as well as her information. She's really, really good at answering back to you guys and getting back to you guys. If you guys have any questions on the fajas and stuff like that, if any of her fajas do sell out, I will keep you guys updated on my Snapchat or on my Instagram once they restock. So yeah, you guys can kind of just browse around. And I will also link down below the pomada that I was using that is for stretch marks, for cellulite, all of that. It is about to be 11 p.m. I think this is the latest that I have ever recorded a video. My eyes are low-key starting to close. But I think for the most part, I covered everything that I wanted to cover with you guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell next to it so you get notified every single time that I post a new video. I love you guys, and I'll see you on my next one. Bye, guys.